Welcome, everyone, to another After Effects tutorial. I'm your host, Elias Arantopoulos. This time around, you will learn how to create a fire effect using the Saber free plugin with custom layer masks. Up next. The first part of this Saber fire effect is about creating this shape where the fire will emit from, and for that we're going to jump into Adobe Illustrator and create a fill pattern. So in this case, I'm going to go up to the window menu, scroll down till I get to the swatches panel. Now, one thing that I always like to do is to have a bigger thumbnail view. So in this case, I'm just going to click on this flat menu and choose large thumbnail view. Now, looking at this text here and looking at the properties panel, as you can see, I'm using a quite heavy font style here for the effect to be more prominent. All right, so what I will do now is talking about patterns inside the swatches panel and at the bottom right here on this icon, which is the swatch libraries menu. I'm going to click on that and scroll down and navigate inside the patterns, basic graphics, and basic graphics dots. From here, with the text layer selected, I'm just going to choose one of these dots here. In this case, I'm going to apply these dots to this text layer. And as I do that, automatically that gets added inside the swatches panel. And here is the pattern we just applied to the text layer. In this case, what I'm going to do is just double click to get into the pattern editing mode. And I'm doing this because I'm going to change the foreground color of the dots here. Now, the foreground color is black, as you can see. So I'm going to marquee select all of these dots and I'm going to apply a white fill color. And then click done. All right, so we got that. What we're going to do now is marquee select with the selection tool, marquee select all of this text layer, go up to the edit menu, copy this into the clipboard, jump to Adobe Photoshop, create a new file, navigate inside the film and video presets. I'm going to use the 1920 by 1080. No need for artboards, just click to create. And let me go ahead and create a new layer here. Go up to the edit menu. I'm going to fill this with black color. Now, you have some choices here, foreground, background, and so on. I just want to use black, click OK, and that gets filled with black. All right, so in this case, I will go up to the edit menu, and I'm going to paste what I copied earlier from Adobe Illustrator. And I'm going to paste this as a smart object to be able to size this up. I'm going to click OK, and then I'm going to hold down the Alt key or the Option key. Just going to drag from the sides here and just size this up, and then hit Enter Return. Now we'll go up to the File menu. I'm going to export that. I will export this as a JPEG, high resolution. Click to export, and I'm going to export this as a Saber shape. Click to save, and now we are ready to go to the next step and import that inside After Effects and create the fire effect. So inside Adobe After Effects, let's go ahead and create a new composition. I'm going to give it a name of Saber Fire. For width and height, we're using 1920 by 1080. Duration doesn't really matter. You can always trim this at the very end and click OK. So what we need to do is, the first thing we need to do is import the JPEG that we exported from Adobe Photoshop, and I'm inside the project window. Just going to right-click, import, import file, and I'm going to choose the Saber shape and click to import. Just going to click and drag this into the timeline and then go up to the Fun menu and save my work. I'm going to save this as Saber Fire Effect and click to save. All right, as you can see, we just have a flat image, but what we need is we need a bunch of mask paths, and the way we can do this is by going to the layer menu and use auto trace command. With the auto trace command, we will be able to create a bunch of masks from the photo, but what is important is to look inside the options and the channel we're going to use. In this case, we have alpha channel, red, green, blue, and luminance. Luminance is great with high contrast and black and white images only. And that's what we have here. We have high contrast and black and white image. I will set the tolerance to 1, and I'm going to leave the rest as is, and click OK. Great. Now looking inside this layer here, if you open this up, you can see bunch of masks that Adobe After Effects has created, which is correct. All right. Now, let's go to the Effect menu. And inside the Video Copilot, I'm going to bring up the Saber plugin here. And of course, the first thing we see is the Light B. All right, so the question is, how can we use all the mask paths we created from the luminance conversion and apply this Saber effect? We're going to do this inside the Effects Controls, and under the Customize Core, go ahead and open this up. And for the core type, instead of Saber, click on the drop-down menu and choose Layer Masks. And here are all the layer masks, the mask paths that we created from the luminance conversion emitting, as we can see here. Great. Now, we can spend a lot of time trying to change so many of these different parameters and options here. But the good thing about the Saber plugin, it comes with a plethora of presets. In this case, I'm going to use the fire preset. All right, now, before I do anything, I want to bring to your attention about the preview resolution. You see, my preview resolution is set to full. So if you drop this preview resolution to something, let's say 1/3, the preview results will be different, as you can see here. So I highly recommend you to bring this to a full preview resolution. All right, let me go ahead and change the glow intensity. I'm going to bring this down to, let's say, between 25%. Okay. Now, these two, the glow bias and the core size, are very important options and parameters to change. The glow bias controls the intensity of the glow towards the core. And the core, in this case, are the dots, are the mask paths we created from the luminance conversion. In other words, the glow bias refers to how tight the glow is going to be coming from the core, coming from the mask paths. So let me go ahead and bring this down to, let's say, 0.1, just to be able for you to see the difference. And the core size, this adjusts the size of the mask paths emitting the glow. So if I bring this down to 1, this is what we'll get. All right, I just want to show you the difference. Again, the core size is the size of the mask paths emitting the glow. I'm going to bring this back to 10. I'm going to set the glow bias to 0.2. So I like what I see. If I do it, if I press the space bar for the RAM preview, this looks good. But let's go ahead and refine this even more. We're going to do this inside the distortion. Inside distortion, we have glow distortion and core distortion. The glow distortion basically refers to the noise amount, and the core distortion refers to the displacement of the core. In this case, inside the glow distortion, I'm going to change. First of all, let's look at the distortion amount. So if I bring this down to 1, this is what we get. We get no noise. That's why I will increase this back to 100. See that? We've got great noise here. For the distortion type, I'm going to change this to from energy smoke. I like that. For the composite, if you change this to distortion, you're going to get a lot of distortion here. So I'm going to switch back to multiply, and then I'm going to check the inversion here. Once I do that, we're going to get more of a smoky look. So I'm going to check on that, and here's the smoky look. I like what I see. Let's go ahead and press the space bar for the RAM preview here. This looks great. You can actually leave this as is. But in this case, what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to continue this and select this layer here and then duplicate this. Now I have two identical ones. For this one, top one, I'm going to change the luminance color. And I'm going to change this to red and perhaps use this kind of a red color here and then click OK. Again, if we leave this as is, then we're not accomplishing anything. As you can see, before, after, I'm not doing anything. But first of all, if we change the blend mode inside the blending mode column from normal to soft light, then we'll get this. But in this case, The glow intensity is way too much, so I'm just going to bring this down to 10. All right. And I'm also going to increase the glow bias to 0.5 to get back some of the noise. And if I run preview, this is what I have. So that will be before and after. Very close, those two blend to each other. Again, this is just a personal choice, but I like what I see on my end. So there is so much one can accomplish using this technique, bringing in custom shapes from Illustrator. So experiment on your end and see what it takes you.